people will often quip that there are as many definitions of leadership as there are people who research it. I would say there are probably as many definitions of leadership also as people who claim the mantle of leader. It's one of those phenomena we observe, we critique, we praise almost on a daily basis, and yet we have a very hard time describing in concrete definitional terms. Leadership is a very young discipline. It's been around since about the mid-1800s and started with the great man theory of leadership. This is where we were looking at leaders as individuals who were born gifted and had special characteristics that inspired the rest of us to follow them. So this look at leadership as the property of an individual carried on until about the 1950s. There was some prior work that was looking at leadership as driven by context, but primarily we were looking at singular individual leaders until about the 1950s. And then we started to look more at the relationships between leaders and followers, but still we really were looking at leadership as the property of an individual. It's really only been in the last, I'd say, 2 or 3 decades where we've started to look at leadership as a process, as not something that an individual leader owns and executes on his or her own, but rather as something that happens when people come together to create change, to define a better future, to set their direction, to align their separate actions toward that direction, and build commitment over time until they bring that future into the present. I had this fantastic opportunity to go to West Virginia and visit with a group called the Ohio Valley Environmental Coalition. When I got there, they took me to the mountains to show me what the coal mining industry was doing. And they drove me up the side of this beautiful mountain with all this green lush forest, and we get to the top and get out and turn around and look, and the rest of the landscape on the other side is just completely barren. The tops of the mountains have been cut off. This was the main target of their leadership and their advocacy and their community organizing work, was to stop the mountaintop removal practices of the coal mining companies. They were 3 women who were working as co-leaders of this coalition. They were actually getting legislation passed to stop mountaintop removal. So one of the things I asked them was how they kept going in the face of threats, personal threats to themselves, in the face of insurmountable amounts of cash on the other side, right? And they said, well, leadership is a lot like walking through the fog. You don't know what the next step is going to be. But if you build relationships with integrity with those around you and you walk together, the next steps will be revealed. So this was an incredibly moving story for me and moment for me to see how people could have the audacity to just step up to leadership on a challenge that seemed insurmountable, and to do it by working with others and developing relations with others, not by amassing any kind of formal authority or power, not by having a particular role or institution behind them, but instead by working with others.